Starting live. Wait, is it working? I'm so confused. How do I internet? Let me just check. Michael Soprano. Is this thing working? How do I know if this is working? It's not showing up on my thing. Tell me if this is working. How would you tell me? You can't talk. You're a computer. Live events. It says live now. 14 people are watching. I think it is working. Hooray to the, all the things. Hold on, let me tweet this ish. It's working, I think. Come watch and hang out and things that are things, right? Okay, let me go on to Facebook. Oh my gosh, that would be time. Okay, here we go. Come on. Wait, I'm back at live chats already, and it's only, I should be checking Twitter and stuff to see if this is even working. Can you see it, Mom? Let's see if I refresh.
Thanks.
I can hear myself. It says it started. It's working. Huzzah, hooray to all, and to all a good night. Let me just post this on my Facebook. Doing a live chat right now. Come hang out and watch me make a Miranda video. Hooray. Oh, that's not how you spell hooray. I spelled it oh hooray. Okay. There we go. I think it's all good now. Hi guys. Sorry that was 5 minutes of horribleness. It's my brother Trent, for those of you that don't know. It's my mommy. They're my special guests today. For those of you that are subscribed to me, which probably all of you are, I'm assuming, you know that last week I didn't upload any videos, and this week I'm not uploading videos. So I thought I would do a live chat, because the reason I'm not uploading videos is because it's too, I got a notification. It is too painful for me to edit, and I basically just need to take time off. So I just miss you guys. I was like, well, I can't just not upload anything. So I wanted to do a live chat today. So, oh, it's working. But you have to turn that off so I don't. Okay. So anyway, I am at my home in Santa Barbara. This is all messed up. Because I needed to take a break and I needed to go to the doctor, and Josh is out of town in Las Vegas. My birthday present to Joshua was to go to Vegas with his best buddies. So I shipped them off to Vegas and I came to Santa Barbara and I saw the doctor today finally. And the doctor gave me a cortisone shot in my shoulder. I haven't explained anything. So I had a really bad shoulder injury, and I guess I got a tear in my rotator cuff. That's what they think. They're not sure. So we're hoping we can fix it with cortisone shots and with physical therapy. But if that doesn't work, then I'll need to get a surgery, which I'm hoping doesn't happen. But it's in my right arm, my right shoulder. So I haven't been able to use my arm. Like, even texting hurts. That's why if you follow me on Twitter, you'll see that I have not been tweeting very much, because it hurts to use my hand to even use my phone. So that's the situation. But enough about that. Hopefully I'm on the right track to making it better, because I went to the doctor today. So I'm just hoping that our plan will make it better. But if this doesn't work, then it might be something else, and I have to go in for an MRI and blah, 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 boring, stupid doctor things. Okay, so Trent.
How do you feel today?
Okay.
Good.
Good. Because it even hurts to straighten my hair, so I can't do my hair. This has just been big old pity party for Colleen. All right, so but I wanted to hang out with you guys and do Colleen's Corner live. So hopefully I'll answer as many questions as possible on here. Use the hashtag. What should the hashtag be? Colleen's Corner Live, I guess. I want it to be something more creative than that. You guys tweet me what you think it should be, because tweet me hashtags right now, whatever hashtags you think would be good for this, and I'll pick one because I'm on Twitter right now, and I will tell you, hold on. I'll tell you actions using that hashtag. I am tweeting as Miranda really quick. And now I'm logging out and logging into Colleen. Sounds like a crazy person. I'm logging into myself. Longest password ever. Thank you, Rachel, for that. Okay, so I'm gonna see what hashtag you guys want it to be. Mentions. Queen's Corner Live, live with the Queen. Colleen goes live party, Colleen is a cookie, Colleen's Corner, Colleen live chatty. A lot of you are just saying Colleen's Corner live. Hashtag Colleen's shoulder. Yeah, let's just do Colleen's Corner live. So tweet me questions with Colleen's Corner live and I will answer as many as I can. Yay, live Colleen's Corner. My mommy's here. If you have questions for my mom, you can ask my mom. If you have questions for Trent, you can ask Trent. If you have questions for me, you can ask me, obviously. This is so weird. I always say that I always go through this, like these moments of when I'm doing a live chat, I'm like, this feels really weird and really boring. Why are people watching? Because I so badly want to like edit it. But I can't edit it. So let's see what questions you have on Twitter. Ryan Lackey 72 said, what's your favorite kind of cat? My favorite kind of cat, I just like cats. I don't know. I don't have a favorite kind as far as like looks. I like all cats. I love munchkin cats. They're really, really cute to me because they have like little short legs and they're so cute. But I just like cats that are willing to cuddle. Like, so I'm not a huge fan of the cats that are super skittish and like won't let you pet them or touch them. I like cuddly cats, like lazy, old, fat cats are my favorite cats.
Cause you're a sweetheart.
Yeah, sweetheart is a good cat.
Our cat, is named Sweetheart, and she lives in the front yard and just loves to come sit on your lap and loves to be pet, and she's just super sweet. All right, let's see. Brooke Scheimer, I think that's how you say your last name, said, what's your favorite piece of fan art? I cannot pick that because I get so much cool fan art from you guys. I'm constantly getting like amazing artwork. Lately, I've been getting a lot of really cool paintings and drawings and art of me and Josh, which I really like a lot. You guys are so freaking talented. I don't have a lot here, but I do have something here at my mom's house that is really cool. Can you get it from the room? It's the drawing of the four kids. I don't have a favorite though. There's no way I could pick a favorite fan art. They're all freaking epic. You guys are so talented. I wish I was that good at anything. But I don't have one favorite. I just like it all. I don't know. And I love I get a lot of fan art from Miranda that I love, but I love when I get ones from little kids. Like a lot of times I'll get like a drawing and you can't even tell what it is. And it's like, my little sister drew this for you. She's two. And those are my favorite. So this is something that's really cool that I got. I think I got this when I was in Europe. Someone drew it. I can't remember now, which I feel really bad, but it's, I just think it's cool because it's so like simplistic. It's just, like there's barely any lines on here, but somehow she made it look like the four siblings, which is really cool. So I gave it to my mom to put in the house here since it's her four kids. I really like that. But I like all the fan art. Like I don't have a favorite. Okay. Let's see. At KWABS girl, Quabs girl. Your username is Colleen, so I don't know if that's your actual name or if you're just doing that because of me, but what up, girl? I love you. She said, do you see me? And I do see you. Well, I don't see you, but I see your tweet. Let's see. Elizabeth Penna said, embarrassing period stories. I have a lot, and I feel like I've already told them in Colleen's Corner episodes. I don't know. They're all embarrassing. Like, is a period story ever not embarrassing? They're all awful. I don't know if I have like one particular one that is like worse than others. At Colleen Live, wow, someone made a Twitter just for the event, said, this is a question for Gwen. What was Colleen like as a kid?
She was very shy.
What?
I was very shy as a little girl.
Really?
Huh?
I don't remember being shy. I know I was like a little art freak. Like I loved doing crafts, not like drawing. I couldn't draw, but I loved doing crafts and I loved playing outside. And I don't know. I was, I never knew I was shy.
You were shy around other people.
Until what age?
Eight.
I was shy, apparently. Interesting. Let's see. I'll refresh. Adri at Colleen's Coco said, ask Gwen if she remembers adopting me.
Totally.
Olivia at 2xxlivyxx2 said, animal that you want most. I want a cat. I really, really, really want a cat. I want two cats, actually. I want two cats. Josh really wants to get kittens. I kind of want to go to the Humane Society and get like two older cats because no one will adopt them and the most likely are to be potty trained and they're just gonna be lazy and they're just gonna want to sit in my lap. And that's what I want, because kittens are so super cute, but they're, you have to train them and they need a lot of attention and care, and I'm gone a lot of the time. So I'd want two cats who could be best friends, who are old and fat and lazy and will just sit on my lap while I edit. So that's what I want. At Goalie Girl 543 said, Trent, what was it like to get your implant? I'm a special ed major. I'm curious. Oh, she's a special ed major, but she wants to know what it was like to get your implant.
I was asleep for when I got
it. They put it in. So Trent has two cochlear implants. So before he got the cochlear implants, he was severely hard of hearing. And so now he can hear a lot more since you got it. So like right now, you can hear me right now, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
You don't even have to look at you if I don't want to.
Yeah, and before he got the cochlear implant, I would have to look at him and really enunciate my words. And now he can just hear me and be part of the conversation, which is really cool. Yeah, so.
I'm doing in the dark now, too.
Yeah, in the dark too, which is crazy. Like it'll be dark outside, we'll be at a bonfire and Trent can hear us and have conversations. So it's really cool. It's a lot of hard work. There are videos online of people getting the cochlear implant and then they can just like, they're crying because it's so amazing they can hear. But most situations, it's not like that. Most situations, it's hard work, lots of training, lots of, right?
A lot of training, you have programs, you have to hear anything in the world. It's awesome to hear.
Yeah.
It's even the smallest cricket.
Yeah. Super cool. So it's very exciting. That's a good question. But it is a lot of work. I went with him when he got it turned on, and I thought they would turn it on, and he'd just be like, oh, I can hear everything. It's easy. But it wasn't like that. It was, he had to train his brain to learn to hear with the cochlear. And it took months of practice, right?
Almost a year, but this one could take a lot longer because he's never heard anything in his life.
Yeah. So it's a long process to be able to hear, but he can hear. But it's great. So
and we sound like robots.
Yeah, he said we sound like robots, but he can hear us. Yeah. So all right. Next question. Just for Boys at Kindness is Free. What a nice screen name. Said, hi, Colleen, my daughter and I love you. Say hi to Michaela Alexis, please. Hi, Michaela Alexis. All right. Megan Lynn at MegTales2513 said, what was your favorite school subject? I liked math. I wasn't good at it, but I enjoyed math a lot. I was really bad at science. I did not like it. I hated science class. But now as an adult, I like science. I think it's really fascinating. And now I really want to learn about it. But as a kid, I didn't care. I didn't want to learn about science. It was so boring to me. My favorite school subject, I mean, it was choir for sure and theater. But does that count as a school subject?
Yes.
I didn't like English. I felt really stupid in English class. What other classes are there? History. I never was interested in history. What was your favorite class in school?
High school?
Yeah, sure.
Graphic design and acting, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, so I like the artsy classes. I like jewelry class. I took jewelry class and I took another art class and I took choir and theater. And those were my favorites. Okay. Let's see. Carter Herbert said, can you find more emo diary? Well, I am home where I grew up, so I'm sure there's something here. Are you gonna go look in the, it doesn't have to be emo, just any like book I used to write. I used to wanna be an author, which when I was really little girl, like when I was like 5, I was in first grade and I remember I wanted to be an author so bad. I wanted to write books. And so I wrote books every day. Like I would get stacks of paper and fold them, staple them, and then write a story in the pages. And so now it's weird that I've actually written a book. I mean, Miranda wrote it, but Miranda's me's, but you know what I mean? It's not like a book written by me, but it's so confusing because I wrote it, but you know what I'm saying? It's not a Colleen book, it's a Miranda book. But that's so crazy that I have like a book that is being published when that was what I wanted to do when I was 5. I mean, I don't think it went past like second grade. I never wanted to be an author past then, but oh man, it was my dream. When I was 5-year-old, I wanted to be an author, so. All right. Let's see, more questions. Just keep tweeting me questions and use the hashtag Colleen's Corner Live because yeah, then I can, that's how I'm looking for them. Alexis Choi said, not a question, but I want to say I love you so much and my day was shitty, sorry. But this live chat cheered me up. Aw, thanks. It cheered me up too. I had to go to the doctor today and that was not fun. So this is cheering me up too. And also I feel weird, like last week I didn't upload anything and it just felt so wrong and so weird. I hated it. And this week I haven't been able to upload. So I've just felt off and I feel like I feel better when I can at least talk to you guys. So I know it's not like a full-on video, but I'm happy that I can be talking to you. ChrissyCat16 said, what is your biggest life-changing event? I hope you respond. Hi, Chrissy. My biggest life-changing event, I feel like I've had a lot of them. Meeting Josh was life-changing, obviously. That was probably the most life-changing for me because now I'm marrying him. life-changing events.
What about my life-changing with the cochlear implant?
What?
My life-changing with the cochlear
implant. Yeah, his life-changing was the cochlear implant. I don't know. My YouTube video going viral was life-changing, but I don't even know if that was the life-changing thing. I think the life-changing part of all of that was deciding to fly to New York and spending every penny that I had to go to New York to try to meet people and perform for free anywhere that I could. And I just made the decision to just go. And I think that really changed my life. If I had had a viral Miranda video and I never went to New York, I don't think I'd be doing this, but I took a risk and I spent all my money on one flight to New York and met the Grandes and they let me stay with them, which was so generous. And then that was almost 6.5 years ago. And that was life-changing because that week I performed all over New York City and I met a lot of people. I met a manager and met some of my lifelong friends, and that was life-changing for me. If I did not take that risk, I don't think I'd be doing this now. So that was life-changing too. So Mom just found some stuff. Oh, she found a letter to the Tooth Fairy. So this is the emo diary section of this live chat. Just imagine that I'm in black and white with some dramatic music playing. Dear Tooth Fairy, did I scribble that out? I lost my second molar. If it's all right with you, I would like either a lot of Jolly Ranchers, money, but the one I want most is a Barbie. And thank you, Colleen. Look how I put a lot of Jolly Ranchers. So the options are Jolly Ranchers, money, or a Barbie. So I'm sure I got a Barbie because my mom, the Tooth Fairy spoiled me.
Probably got all three.
Yeah, I probably got all of them spoiled. So here's a new one. I don't know that I've even read this one. Oh, this is fun. This is called Memories. When would I make this, I wonder?
If you were like 10 or 11.
Memories. So the first little flap, I hate that word, is just a really good drawing. As you can see, I'm really talented. And it says by Colleen Ballinger. So I'm just a really good artist. This one, oh my gosh. Okay. So here's the picture. And it says skills. The memory I liked the least is Skills, just out there slaving away in the hot sun. Skills must have been like PE class or something, because I hated PE. I hated anything athletic, anything where I had to be in the sun. I still do. Like, I hate doing exercise, anything. So that's probably what that was. Slaving away. Oh my God. Okay, the next one. Is this just a complaint book? This is called Memories, and all these pages are about how I don't like things. So there's the picture of stuff, and it says homework. I don't like homework that much because there are better things I could be doing, like even going to the beach or even watching TV. Wow. So the next one is Jogathon, and there is a sweating horrible girl. I didn't like the jogathon that much either because I got too hot and sweaty. I would rather do schoolwork. So I'd rather do schoolwork than a jogathon, but I'd rather go to the beach or TV. This is funny. This project was clearly like memories, write about your favorite things over the school year. And I just wrote about how I hated everything. So positive clean. So this next one is called PE, and there is a circle of people. It says everybody else, Roseanne, me, and Kathy, who were like my best friends for a couple years in elementary school. I do not like PE. It's the same as Skills, just out there in the hot, hot sun, even doing laps. Parentheses, I do not like it. It's a really positive little girl. Mondays. There's the picture. That's my bunk bed. I'm up there. And that's my mom, I'm assuming. It says, honey, wake up. It's 8. I do not like Mondays. I love sleeping in. And that's mostly what I do all weekend. And when my mom wakes me up, well, you don't want to know. The next one is a picture of me and my friends in elementary school. And I named them all. So funny. I don't talk to any of those girls anymore. It's so weird. And there's a cat that had kittens. In the 1996-1997 school year, I've had the best friends I have never had because they are nice, fair, kind, loving, you name it. I like my friends from the 1996-1997 school year. So what? How old was I then?
So now you know that's when you wrote it.
1996. I can't do math.
10.
I was 10. Okay. Was I?
10 and 11.
I don't know. So this is, oh my gosh, mom, we still have this somewhere.
Yes, I still have that.
Where is that?
Let me go see if it's in the hope chest.
Okay, so I had to make this thing. This is probably the most boring thing you guys have ever watched. I can't believe I'm still going. I love art. It is so fun. My favorite project is something I call My Kitty. I haven't changed. It was the sculptures we made. My sculpture was a girl in overalls holding a brown cat. She had pigtails in her hair. Her pockets had gumballs and suckers in them. Her back pocket has a chocolate bar that has a bite out of it. I remember making this, and it's, oh my God, you still have it!
Of course, one ponytail fell off.
And the cat is gone too. So this, I made this. Oh my gosh, I can't believe you still have this. Hollister, so I was in grade 5.
That's 10 years old. So you would have been 9 and 10.
Yeah. So this is the sculpture I made. And there's her chocolate bar that's supposed to have a bite taken out of it, but really just looks like a log of poo. And there was a cat there at some point. Oh my God, how funny that she still has this.
Here's the cat.
This is how talented I am, guys. This is the trophy here that proves my talents.
Here's the cat.
Oh my gosh. This is so good. Oh my gosh. This is awful. I just shattered something that's 20 years old. This is something I did in ceramics class. It's a really creepy Satan person holding a Darth Vader baby. Wow, that's really awful. See, guys, I told you I was talented. Okay. Then there's a party. I'm still going with this, going strong. Parties were so fun. Instead of doing schoolwork, sometimes we have parties. For instance, popcorn parties, movie parties, music parties, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Like, whoa, a woman with lots of hands. I loved it when I went to LA. The whole reason I even went there was for my brother. He is hard of hearing, Trent, and I went down there to learn sign language, and now I know over 700 words in sign language, and I have been practicing my ABCs, and the last time I did them in 7 seconds. I love sign language. Yeah, I did do that. That was very fun. All right. And then there's a picture of me, Rachel, Christopher, and Trent. And it says, my 10th birthday was a lot of fun, and I mean a lot. And that's it. So there you go. That's your emo diary for the day. I do need to make a Miranda video, so I will do that if you guys stay tuned. Promise it's coming. It's coming. Let's see. Lindsay G, Blondie Blue 10, said shoe size. My shoe size is 8, which I thought that was like a normal shoe size, but then like every time I tell someone my shoe size is 8, they're like, wow, you have really big feet. And I'm like, I feel like it's really normal, but thanks for making me insecure. So is that big? I don't know. Is that a big shoe size? I don't know, but I always get made fun of when I tell people my shoe size is 8, so. Let's see. I'm looking through this hashtag. Use the hashtag Colleen's Corner Live if you want to ask me a question. What Veronica V. Cali 25 said, what is one of your favorite things about Miranda? I like that Miranda, I mean, it's weird because it's like I'm talking about myself, but I like that Miranda says whatever she wants and has no filter, because I'm not like that. And a lot of times people are like, why don't you just tell people what you think, what you feel? I'm like, because I don't want to hurt anyone's feelings. But as Miranda, I can say whatever I want. So I think that's my favorite thing about playing Miranda. Liam at Daggy Dallas said, bit of a sad question, but would you rather be hated or forgotten? I'd rather be forgotten, because I would never want to be hated. Being hated means that there's a reason people hate me. Like, they hate me for something I did or a way that I act. And being forgotten, everyone's going to be forgotten someday anyway, sad as that is. So I'd rather be forgotten, I guess. I don't know. That is a sad question. Womp, womp. Megan Latini said, when are you going to do a house tour? I am so excited to do a house tour, but our house is still, it's not done. Like, so Josh and I moved to a new house like 2 months ago, and we haven't shown you guys the house yet because the only things that we have furniture in is our bedroom and our living room and our dining room. Everywhere else just doesn't really have furniture yet. So, but we are working on my Queen's Corner office. So right now I want to show you a picture, because when I got home, my amazing designer, who is brilliant, just snuck into my house and like put some stuff in there. I don't know. You can't really tell, but it's cute. She just did one little corner. This isn't going to be Colleen's. Whoa, it's rainbows. It's not going to be Colleen's Corner. It's just part of the office. So like while I'm editing or working in there, someone can sit in that chair, and it has like a sparkly pillow and like a big wood mirror and like this little side table. It's cute. So she's making it really like simple and clean. And yeah, I'm excited about it. Okay, let's see here. Well, I'm getting all these text messages. Oh, Heather. Hi, Heather. I don't know if you're still working or if you're still watching, and Christina too. I love you guys. Thanks for watching. You're probably not watching anymore because this is really boring. Okay, back to Twitter. I need to film this Miranda video, but I'm like not wanting to. Oh, Jordan's calling me. I'll call back. Okay. Let's see. I'll answer 3 more questions, and then I'm going to make a Miranda video.
Can you grab that stick?
Yes. Thanks, Ma. And if you can find hair clips, too. Okay. Thank you. Let's see. I love you, Sarah. Let's see. Jesse Henderson said, what's your advice for aspiring YouTubers? I'd like to hear some Colleen uniqueness to this question. I don't know what that means, Colleen uniqueness. Does that mean you want me to try to be, I don't know what that means. My advice to aspiring YouTubers is, the best thing I think I did for my own channels was to have a consistent schedule. So saying I'm posting Miranda videos on Mondays and Thursdays, and I'm posting my videos on Tuesdays and Fridays, gave me a schedule, which made it like a real job. So I had to post these videos on these certain days at certain times, and it made me have a schedule, and I was consistent, and that really helped the numbers to grow, and it helped me to be creative and come up, I don't know. I just feel like that was one of the best things I did. And the other thing is super corny, but it's to be yourself. I feel like YouTubers, people who watch YouTubers can tell like if it's super scripted or if they're not acting like themselves, and they're not gonna wanna watch. Because the point, in my opinion, of YouTube is for entertainment, yes, but it's also to like create a relationship with your viewers. So to me, it's not like I'm making videos for just people and strangers. Like, to me, I'm making videos for my friends. So when I make videos, I'm like, I want them to know the real me, and I want to make my friends laugh. Like, that's kind of how I approach it. So if you approach YouTube like a job, like, yes, it's a job, but if you approach it like, how am I going to get the most subscribers? How am I going to get the most views? That's all I care about is the money. Like, I don't think you'll be as successful. I mean, maybe you will, but for me, that's not how it was. It had to be a more sincere thing, because I've been on YouTube for 7 years, and I think part of the reason it's been good for me is because I've like made an effort to become friends with you guys and talk to you a lot and write back to you as much as I can when you guys write to me and get to know you. And it's cool because now when I go on tour, I get to meet people that I've been talking to on Twitter. Like, I think there's someone at every single show that I'm like, oh my God, you're Colleen's Cookie from Twitter. Like, and I recognize people because I've become friends with you guys. So to me, it's not like, these are my fans. It's like, no, these are my friends. Like, I've gotten to know them. And sometimes when you guys meet me, you'll come up to me and you'll cry, and it makes me cry. And like, I don't know. It's more of a, I think my biggest advice is consistent schedule to make it like, I don't know, like a job, but remember that it's not just a job. It's a relationship with people. It's a community. So that's my advice. Okay, I'm gonna answer one more, and then I'm gonna turn it to Miranda. That was a really long answer. I'm sorry. I hope that was the clean uniqueness you requested. Let's see. At Callum69 with me said, "What is your favorite vacation you've ever been on?" I've been on a lot of fun vacations. I don't know. I think my favorite vacation I've ever gone on was a Disney cruise with my sister for her birthday 3 years ago. We just had so much fun on that cruise. That was really, really fun. I don't know. I also really loved Gatlinburg, Tennessee. Josh and I went to Gatlinburg, and Pigeon Forge were like Dollywood is, and I thought I was gonna hate it there, no offense, but to anyone who like lives over there, but I was like, what could possibly be in this random little town? And I had so much fun. I don't know, I tend to have fun on like all my vacations. I'm not that picky. Okay, so I'm going to turn into Miranda really quickly, but let me see. About to turn into Miranda. Watch. People watch. So, here's the situation. I have to make a Miranda video promoting my shows that are coming up in a couple of weeks in Northern California. So, I need to get the dates because I don't know my own schedule, so I'm really cool. Let's see, Stockton, Oakland, and Reading, but I don't know the days. You guys, I'm the worst. I don't know how to own my show days. My shows that are in like 2 weeks. I don't know the days. Wait, that's not in 2 weeks. When is that? I don't know anything. I'm just really the worst person. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. Trent. Okay, so I have to turn into Miranda. This is so weird. I've done this once before on a live chat. A long time ago. It was like back when I would have like 4 people watching live chats. Oh, that's another thing about, that's another thing about YouTube. I will say one more thing. I know I was long-winded before, but I'm very passionate about YouTube. Is that a lot of people get frustrated when they start on YouTube and their numbers aren't growing right away. And they're like, well, I'm consistent every week and I've been doing it for a month. And I'm like, okay, well, that's not how it works. Like, it takes a long time. Like, so that's the other thing, is be patient, because I didn't make money on YouTube for like, until like I was doing YouTube for like 4 years. And even then I didn't make enough money to live on it. It was like, I'd get like a check for $50. Like, it wasn't anything big. You have to be passionate about it in order for it to become like a real thing. That's my advice. Anyway, stop talking about that. I'm gonna turn into Miranda. Here's lipstick. Wait, I don't think Miranda would wear this shirt. So I'm gonna
want to dance.
Yeah. Okay. So I have to make a video promoting these upcoming shows, but I also need to make another video. So you guys, if you are in the live chat, you get to tell me what you think the other video should be. So, should it be a Q&A? Should I? Thanks, Mom. Oh, wow. Dad even has a Miranda shirt. This is my daddy's shirt. If you guys think it should be a Q&A, or I don't know, what can I do sitting here? I don't want to have to like get up and walk around, because I don't want you guys to miss it. Who's that? Andrew!
Wait, doing a live chat.
Oh. This is my cousin Andrew. Hey. Andrew is the coolest ever. Did you see Josh's vlog?
Yes. It's hilarious.
So good. Andrew is the coolest guy ever. I love Andrew. Anyway, how you been, man? Are you sticking around for a while?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. All right. So the first video is going to be promoting these shows. So here we go. Okay. So I'm going to do it on my phone. I can't show Trent's face. How should I do this? I want a really ugly angle. I'm wearing too much eye makeup. How do I do this? Okay. Okay, here we go. Gotta get that ugly angle. I'm kind of nervous. It's weird doing a random video knowing I'm being watched. This is so weird. Okay. I'm like, why am I nervous? I've been doing random for so long. Why would I ever be nervous about this? Okay. How do I want to talk about this? This is... I'm trying to think how I can promote the Northern California shows without just being like, Northern California shows. I don't know. Okay. Hey guys, it's me, Miranda. So I have some really, really exciting news for you. I'm not kidding about it. I have been hearing about the Northern California area, and from what I've heard, there's lots and lots of wine up there. And so I'm really disappointed about that, because wine is only supposed to be drunken by the sinners. That is why Jesus turned the wine into water in the Bible times. So that means that it is my job to go up to Northern California and stop the sinners. So I have a few shows coming up there, and you need to get tickets to it, and you can watch me stop all the sinners. The shows are in Stockton, California, Oakland, and Redding, and they're on May 14th, May 16th, and so 14th, 16th, 17th. Those are the days of those shows. Now, there are sinners all over the world, which is why I'm still on tour everywhere. So I'm also going to be pretty much everywhere else. So check in the description below to see if I'm coming to a city near you, and tell me what sinners I need to be praying for. So make sure to get your tickets now. They will sell out. No kidding. I'm very popular. All right. Thanks, guys. And I'm going to eat some. All right. Congratulations. You just watched a random video be made. I don't know if you could even see me, because I was like this the whole time. So now I have that and I can upload it. Good day. So now I want to make another Miranda video, and you guys can watch me make it. So use the hashtag Colleen's Corner Live, and I'm searching it. Thanks, Mom. Could you bring my, sorry to make you just like do things, I feel bad, but my makeup, I think it's in my bedroom on the bed, so that after I take off the lipstick, I can fix my makeup. Stop the sinners. Okay, let's see what other type of video you guys want me to do. I will check the hashtag. Someone said cough. It's not truly a video. Stop the sinners. Let's see. A lot of people are saying Q&A. A makeup tutorial. Oh, I know what I'll do. The makeup tutorial is a good idea. I'll do makeup tutorial, but I need to wipe off the makeup I'm currently wearing to do a makeup tutorial, which is a huge bummer. I'll just redo it. Mommy, do you have any black eyeliner that you don't mind me using? Because mine won't come off as well. Look at me just bossing my mother around. What a douchebag. So a makeup tutorial. It's been a while since I've done one of those, so I will do that. And then I will send it to my sister to edit, since my arm will fall off if I use my arm. Let's see. Are you guys bored yet? Andrew, I'm so glad you're here.
What?
I'm glad you're here. I was miss you. It didn't feel right being here last night without you here.
I thought you were gonna be a guest today.
So you came over because you thought I wasn't gonna be here?
Maybe.
Rude! Douche.
I'm kidding.
No, I was, but Bailey was sick last night, and I can't get sick because I'm going to San Francisco this weekend. Mm-hmm. So I am really sad, but I'm going to stop by there on the way to LA tomorrow to pick up Josh. Wow. How much more Miranda do I look now without that makeup on?
I have a brown pencil and this black.
Yeah, I think the brown pencil will work best. Do you mind if I use this?
Not at all.
Okay. I'm going to make sure my face is dry. Okay, so.
Oh, I'm in frame. I didn't know that.
It's okay. I need to do this. All right, so now I'm gonna film a makeup tutorial. This will probably go up on Thursday. But it won't be the same as what you're watching right now. So you guys get to watch the raw footage of the makeup tutorial that will go up on Thursday, which will be an edited video. So I don't know how long this is gonna be, but here we go. I hope I have enough room on my phone for this. Maybe I should delete an app or two. I still have an old phone that has like no room. I would use my vlog camera, but I think it's dead. I'm gonna get my backpack really quick and check. Mom, will you entertain the fans for a moment while I go in?
I don't know what to say. Here we are in the living room. I had fun in Australia. Help, Andrew.
I don't know what to do.
Help, Trent.
Tell them about your chickens.
This is, I have 10 chickens. This is Trent. Colleen got a new purse. It has a charger inside of it. Pretty fancy design. See? It's built into the purse. This is another lovely little artwork Colleen did.
Colleen did that?
Yeah, when she was little.
Really?
Her.
Don't you make fun of my artwork.
She's coming back.
Okay. I love that they scurry like mice when I come back into the room. I found my vloggy, so I'm hoping that this vloggy will be better than the other options. Okay. Oh, I don't have, I just did something to my computer. Okay. How can I set this up so that I can do a makeup tutorial? But I still have the live chat going. No, I don't need you to hold it. I just need to place it nicely. Okay, I think that's good. Wow, I look so ugly. It's perfect. Okay. Okay, so here I go. I'm gonna do a makeup tutorial. Hopefully you guys can see me. I'm gonna tilt it this way so that, let's see if I get this close. You guys, okay, cool. Now you guys can see me. Here's the second Miranda video I'm gonna do. Oh, I need to take off. Mom, will you put on my engagement ring?
I do.
I do. Okay. Here we go. Oh no, my battery's flashing. I have to do this really fast. Hey guys, it's me, Miranda. So I asked you on Twitter what you wanted to see today, and lots of you said a makeup tutorial. So it's been a while since I did this, so of course, here we go. So I've noticed lately that it's really popular to do the cat eye makeup tutorial. That's not right. See, YouTubers mess up and then you have to edit. So I've noticed lately that a lot of people have been requesting that I do a cat eye makeup tutorial, and I think this is a great idea. I love cats, and I've heard that the cat eye makeup look is really popular right now. So here we go. First thing you need to do is have a French face. So as you can see, I look really French, really good. So then you need a makeup pencil. I tried this with a colored pencil and with a crayon. Did not work. You have to use this kind. Also, don't use a Sharpie. I learned my lesson the hard way with that, unless you like tattoos. Oh, insufficient space on card. No. Oh, the life of a YouTuber, the struggles. Oh my gosh. And my battery's like completely flashing at me and dying. Oh no, guys, this is bad news bears. Crap. Okay, hopefully, I'm nervous. I might have to reshoot on my phone. Okay. All right, so I highly recommend using a makeup pencil. Don't use a crayon or a color pencil. Those don't work from experience. And do not use a Sharpie either, because unless you like tattoos, which you don't because you're not a sinner. So here you go. You take the pencil and you simply draw like this. This is for the cat eyes. Like this. And then now cats have really like sharp looking eyes. Like, what does that look like? I don't know the name of it, but I'll show you. Like these. And like these. And then color it in. So that looks like a cat eyes. And then you do the same one on this side, like this. Like this. Ow! Stop! It's not fair. What needs to poke someone? Like that. So now, looks all. Okay, good. So then, of course, you need a whisker. A whisker. Like that. So now, when I close my eyes, look. See, do I look like a cat? Do I look like a cat? Let me check it. I have to take a picture to see if I look like a cat. It's not really good enough. Meow. 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 So that's a cat eye tutorial. So make sure to try out this tutorial look. Here, I'll give you a closer look at it. So make sure to try out this tutorial and send me Instagram photos. My Instagram is Miranda Sings Official. Use the hashtag Miranda Sings Cat Eye so that I can see your beautiful makeup tutorials so that I can see your beautiful makeup pictures of you trying out this look. I really like it. I think it's really fun. And you can keep your eyes closed all day long, which I really like. So try it out. Don't forget to check me out on tour. I am on tour right now, going all over the world. Also, don't forget to buy my book. You will learn this tutorial of this makeup on my book, and also lots of other makeup tutorials and other things in my book. So pre-order it now, MirandaSings.com, or else you didn't do it. So, thanks guys. Hope you have a good day. Okay, thanks for watching.
Oh, God.
That looks so creepy. There we go. That is how you film a Miranda video. Fun! Okay. I can't believe the battery lasted that long. It certainly did not want to. Okay, so. Oh my gosh. Now I'm going to take off my makeup, which is scary. There you go, guys. That is how you film a Miranda video. I promised you I'd film a Miranda video during this live chat. There you go.
That was
ridiculous. So stupid. And now you guys get to see me with no makeup on my face, which is a very scary thought. And now you get to watch a makeup tutorial of how I put on makeup. Watch as the numbers disappear. Ooh, my hair is busted. I am a mess. This is not a pretty day for me. I look so cute. Oh my gosh. Don't you wish you were me right now? Okay. Here, Mom, you should probably take this before I ruin it. Oh man, yeah. I look so busted. So now I can do makeup while I answer more questions. I don't know how long I want this live chat to be. What time did I start? 5? Oh, I've already been doing it an hour. Oh my gosh, that's too long. Wow, I look so busted. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait to put on makeup. Hey Mom, would you mind looking through the questions and just asking me them while I put on makeup so that I can like pay attention to my makeup, like putting makeup on back on? So just look through this hashtag Colleen's Corner Live and just like refresh and just tell me what they say. Okay, I'm gonna put on makeup because I'm terrifying myself. I can't believe I am on camera without makeup on. This never happens. I guess it does when I'm Miranda, but okay.
Okay, Allison Mitchell wants to know, what makeup wipes do you use that took the makeup off so easily? What?
The makeup wipes that I like are the Neutrogena ones, the makeup remover cleansing towelettes. I go through these like crazy, you wouldn't believe, because I use them every single day, not only to take off my own makeup, but I use them to take off Miranda's makeup. But they're really good. There's not really one makeup, look at this color, it's like not even the color of my skin. There's not really one makeup brand that does it better than others. They're all kind of the same to me. But I like Neutrogena's, the one that I use most often, usually because they're on sale for like a 2-for-1 pack.
Nicole Galvez says, can you tell Andrew that I love his laugh?
Dude, I love his laugh. His laugh is amazing.
Oh, these names are hard to say.
It's okay.
Jalfie Butler says, how do you think of ideas so quickly?
You guys, I got that idea from you. You guys said to do a makeup tutorial on Twitter when I was looking through them. So I wanted to do a Q&A as Miranda, but those take more time because I have to go through and find the questions I want to answer and like screenshot them. So you guys give me the ideas actually. So thank you for that.
Kira says, if you could kiss two celebrities, one male, one female, who would they be and why? P.S. I love you.
Two celebrities. I wouldn't want to kiss anyone but Joshua.
Good answer. Aideen says, if you hadn't started YouTube, where do you think you'd be today?
I think if I hadn't started YouTube, I would still be performing in like around the LA area. Like I was working at Disneyland. I need more concealer under my eyes because girl, this ain't cute. I'd probably still be working at Disneyland maybe. I don't know. I've always wanted to open up a theater school for kids and I think I'll still do that someday. So maybe I would have already done that. But that's something I've always wanted to do. So maybe that. I also was in cosmetology. I had applied and gotten into cosmetology school right when the first Miranda video went viral. So I really wanted to do hair and makeup. Can't you tell? But that's, I really was interested in that and I still am. So I don't know. I'm pretty, not to toot my own horn, but I'm pretty ambitious as a person. Like I like to do lots of things at once, lots of different projects and stuff. So I wanted to perform, but I also wanted to go to cosmetology school and open up my own beauty salon. I also wanted to start a theater school for kids. I wanted to, there's so many different things that I've wanted to do throughout my life. And I think what are you laughing at?
Andrew tweeted at me.
Oh, yeah, tweet Andrew. What is it? What's your Twitter? No, you don't want them to?
Okay. Andrew, Atrent824.
You don't have to. Now it's too late.
Simon did a screen capture.
Okay.
Okay.
Wait, before I do this, I'm just going to say I'm putting on bronzer and everyone makes fun of my bronzer, so just get over it. Everyone's always like, you need to learn to contour. Well, I'm not a makeup guru. I'm Miranda, so I don't know how to do it.
Caroline wants to know what your happiest moment is with Josh, was with Josh.
My happiest moment with Josh. I don't know. We have a lot of happy moments. I don't know. I really like seeing Josh with my family. Like, that makes me really happy. Good timing. I love seeing Josh with my family. Ain't nobody got time for that.
I'm gonna
set my phone. Oh, Jesus. Oh, my gosh. It's because people are tweeting you.
I'm not used to this.
Oh, no. Andrew, turn off your notifications. I don't know. I have a lot of happy moments with Josh, but I love seeing Josh with my family. That makes me really happy. And I really enjoyed the weekend after we got engaged, a year ago, actually. Yesterday was yesterday the 5th? The 6th. Whenever the 5th was.
Sunday.
Was the 1 year anniversary of us getting engaged. And after we got engaged, we went to these cabins near Branson, Missouri, Big Cedar Lodge. And it's our favorite place in the world. Like, we want to go back so bad, but it's really expensive to get to Branson, Missouri. For some reason, the flights are always really expensive. It's like cheaper to fly to Hawaii, which is weird because it's in Missouri. Like, you would think it would be not expensive to get there. But we really had a great weekend there. So I think that was a good memory too. Anyway, long answer.
What's your favorite TV show and what character from it would you say you're most like? That's from Lydia.
Oh, that's a good question. My favorite TV show changes. Right now, I'm always super into Survivor. That's like probably my favorite TV show. But there's not a character I feel like I'm most like. I think you mean like a scripted show. I like Honey Boo Boo. Not so much anymore after all the like drama that's happened, but I'd say I'm most like Alana, the Honey Boo Boo. I don't know. It's a really good question. Oh, I love Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt. It's a really good show on Netflix. You guys should watch it. I don't think I'm like anyone on that show. Okay, sorry. I got
one of your top favorite musicals. That is from Sarah E12.
Top favorite musicals. I like Big Butts and I Cannot Lie. My favorite. So weird. I hate myself. My favorite musical is Into the Woods by Stephen Sondheim. That's my favorite musical.
Manage Me, I'm a Mess says, what goes through your head when you break character on stage during a show? Which is hilarious when you
do. It happens a lot. What goes through my head is usually pull it together, because I'm the type of person where if you get me laughing, I don't stop. And so usually it's like, I'm like, okay, pull yourself together. You can do this. Think of something serious. And I just try to make myself stop laughing. But that's kind of what goes through my head when I laugh on stage.
Andrew, do you have any ones?
What?
You can refresh. Oh,
does Miranda have a dad? I have a feeling that her dad is her uncle. Oh, you can refresh. Okay,
Miranda has a dad. I can't tell you anything else, but Miranda has a dad. You'll find out information on Miranda's family hopefully soon, but I don't know. Hollywood is weird.
Andrew is the most, whoa, I just lost it.
It's okay.
Andrew is the ultimate best friend. His laugh reminds me of Tyler Oakley.
Yeah, his laugh is pretty amazing.
Yes.
Whenever I have a show, I'm like, Andrew, you have to be there, because even if no one in the audience laughs, I know you will, and you'll make me look funny. And whenever like someone important is coming to my show, like in LA, a lot of times like these big executive people will come to my shows and I'm really nervous. And I'm like, Andrew, you have to come and sit near the executives so that they think I'm really funny, because his laugh is so good.
Daisy wants to know, who gets the spiders out of your house, you or Josh?
Josh, oh my gosh, I would never. I can't get near spiders.
Can you do impressions of other YouTubers? Abby wants to know.
I can't. I'm not good at that. I don't know. I can't. What's up, internet?
Okay.
Someone asked why you stopped doing intros. the theme intro?
Oh, I wasn't getting as many entries as before. And like I used to do the Colleen's Corner, you ask her your questions and she replies, her answers are lame, but at least she tries Colleen's Corner. And then I started using intros that you guys sent me. And I loved them all so much, but I also saw, there's a couple times where I posted intros that other people wrote and people were writing mean comments about them. And that really upset me because they put hard work into it and people can write rude comments about me and I can get over it, but like they're kids, like how could you do that? So I kind of got annoyed at that. And also I wasn't getting as many entries, but if you guys want me to put them back in, I will. I just, I don't know. I get really sensitive if people like make fun of you guys. So I was like, I don't know if I want to do this anymore. Cause I don't want, I would be horrified if one of you worked really hard on an intro for me and then in the comments they read something mean. So if you guys all promise to be really, really nice to each other and be really supportive of whoever gets to be the intro for my video, I'll put it back in. So start sending me Colleen's Corner intro videos of you and your friends singing the song. Get creative, because the more creative it is, the more likely it is I'll use it instead of if you just sing it to the camera. So.
Okay, Ian wants to know how long it took you to write and videotape the My Family music video.
Forever. To write it took like a day. I wrote it with Christopher. It didn't take that long. We didn't work that hard on the lyrics. We were more excited about like filming it with the family. Filming it took one day, I think. And editing took a week.
Who is your favorite queen on Drag Race?
I'm really sad to say I don't have a favorite this season. I'm really bummed because I love RuPaul's Drag Race, and every year when I watch it, I have like a favorite queen. Like I like, it's like no question. Last year, I loved Bianca from the beginning, and I also really loved Adore. I love Courtney too, but like Adore and Bianca stood out to me. And this year, there's not one that stands out. I kind of like, I don't know. There's no one that stands out to me. Anyway, I've been putting on eyeshadow for like 30 minutes. Everyone's probably like, Queen, give it a break. It's never gonna look good. Anyway, I'm nervous because people are watching me. I'm like, what are they thinking? Okay, sorry. Anyway, Mom.
Alex wants to know, top three favorite college memories.
I'm not a big fan of the college that I went to, but I did have good memories there, like with my friends. Top three favorite college memories? My friend Heather, who has been on my Instagram probably a lot recently, she was in a Colleen's Corner recently, like maybe a month ago, a few weeks ago. She's blonde. She's really cute. She was my absolute best friend. We always joked about how we were married in college because we acted like we were married. We were so in love with each other. She's amazing. I don't know if she's still watching. Probably not, but she said she was watching earlier. One of my favorite memories from college was something she did for me once. Wow. Look how bad my makeup looks. Anyway. I was really stressed at school. I can't even remember what was going on, but I was just stressed and I was really tired. And I came home from school one day and she had gone grocery shopping for me and filled my apartment with groceries, which was so sweet. It's such a little thing, but it was something that like, I just didn't have time to go grocery shopping and I didn't have the money to go grocery shopping. And she just went and bought me all my groceries. And I just remember walking in and feeling like I was gonna cry because it was so sweet of her to do. So that was one of my favorite memories. I went to Joshua Tree once, which is this really cool desert with a few friends in college. And we stayed there overnight to watch the sunrise, and that was a really cool memory. And I don't know. I just loved like drinking wine and listening to music and hanging out with my friends. But I don't know. I wasn't like a party girl. I never did anything crazy. I just liked having a glass of wine with a few friends and like talking and laughing. So I don't know. Those are my favorite memories.
That's a good one.
What is it?
Jonah at JJ Bunyo said, what is Colleen most looking forward to in the future? Besides the wedding, of course.
The wedding. I'm looking forward to having kids. I'm excited to have kids. I don't know.
What's your favorite part of the Miranda show? Victoria wants to know.
Oh, man. I don't know. That's a hard question. My favorite part of the Miranda show. There's a new song I did with Josh in Australia, which I don't think I'm going to do anymore because Josh doesn't travel with me anymore. But it was a duet I did with him, which was really fun. And actually, the duet I do with Josh at the beginning of the show, which if you've come to my show, you've probably seen it, is a really sweet moment. Like, we both talk about, this is so corny, but we both talk about how sometimes we forget that we're performing on stage. Oh my God, I've lost like 1,000 viewers. Everyone's so bored of me. Anyway, but there's a sweet moment where he like puts his hand on my face and looks me in the eye. And every time, like, techies at the theaters are always like, I don't know if that was real love or fake love, but that's a sweet moment. And Josh and I are like, no, that, like, every moment we look at each other and we are smiling like from ear to ear looking at each other. That's a really sweet moment because we don't even feel like we're performing. We're just like, I don't know. That's super corny, but I love that moment a lot.
And you do that in soundcheck too.
Mm-hmm.
It's just really sweet. What's a place you want to go but haven't yet? That's from Aiden at Aiden High.
I want to go to Bali. But I don't know. I've always wanted to go into those little huts that are like over the ocean in Bali and like stay in one of those huts. Do you know what I'm talking about? They're really cute.
This huts over the water.
Yeah.
Like a bungalow.
Yeah, bungalow. That's the name.
A lot of people want to know what hair products you use.
Today, nothing. I usually use I've started using some sort of like heat protectant because my hair is really fried and nasty and split ends. It's gross. So I need to protect it because I straighten it pretty often. But when I don't usually use anything when I straighten it except for a heat protector and hairspray. But when I have it curly, I use a product called Curl Keeper that you can get on Amazon, and I highly recommend it. I love it. And I also use a gel, it's a curl cream by Moroccan Oil or something, and it's called a curl cream. And those are the two that I use to curl my hair.
A lot of people are asking, who helped you come up with the Miranda dance?
Christopher, my brother, helped me come up with the lyrics, and so did Corey DeSoto, my best friend, and the actual choreography I came up with.
Here's one. Joshua Parks wants to know, how did you decide on the Miranda look?
It happened over time through haters. So whatever haters said they hated, I would do more. So the lipstick, people were in the comments were like, I hate your lipstick, learn how to put on lipstick. And then same thing with how I talked and how I dressed. I just didn't want to look pretty. I think that was my main thing. And I knew I looked ugly with the middle part. So I started doing the middle part from the beginning. I wanted my forehead to look really, really big because it already is big, but I wanted it to look bigger.
This is a question for Trent. What's your favorite Ambio at the moment? What's your favorite, am I saying that
Amiibo.
Right? Amiibo.
There's too many.
Well, what's your favorite one right now?
Trent, explain what that is.
Amiibo is basically a figure that goes onto the gamepad and it acts inside the game. You like can use it to play as.
Like a flash drive.
Saves
data and game saves, stuff like that.
Abby Simpson wants to know if you've ever sleepwalked.
I don't think so, Mom. That's a question for you, I guess.
No, that would be Christopher and Rachel. They would. Would you rather eat sushi or cookies for the rest of your life?
Depends on the cookies, depends on the sushi. But I would probably say sushi because there's more nutrients, and with cookies, I would just probably die from a sweet attack.
Okay. Are you obsessed with kale as much as Joshua is?
I'm not obsessed. I like kale. I've liked kale for a really long time, though. I was cooking kale. Josh and I used to live in New York, and like 5 years ago, and I would cook kale all the time then. He's like, what are those green thingies? And he never wanted to try it. And I used to make him sauteed kale, and he was like, it's all right. And then a couple years ago, he started to like the sauteed kale. And then when he started to get more fit and more in shape, he started to be like, well, what's another snack? And I was like, I can make kale chips. I've been making kale chips since I was a nanny in New York. Like 4 or 5 years ago, I was a nanny in New York City for two kids. And their mom always requested I make healthy snacks. So I learned how to make kale chips and stuff for them. So I'm just going to say, I'm putting it out there. I've been eating kale and making kale for like 6 years. And Josh now is obsessed with it, which I'm so glad because it's delicious and healthy. But I'm just going to throw it out there that I was doing it before. It was cool.
Okay, let's see here. Do you want to make more original songs?
For Miranda? Yeah. I wrote one, then I never posted it. Do you guys want to hear it?
Yes.
The, oh my gosh, I've literally lost so many viewers. I need to stop doing this because no one's watching. I'm going to show you an exclusive Miranda song. I might still post it. I just have to change some of the lyrics.
Oh yeah. Listen up, babe.
It was for Valentine's Day.
You want to have the best Valentine ever? I'll show you the way. Your Valentine should be flaky and make you happy.
Your Valentine should be sick to make you happy.
Your Valentine should be salty and tasty as can be.
Talking about your
balance. Your Valentine should be spicy and smell like lots of meat. You wanna know how to get this bang? You just simply ask a pizza to be your Valentine. From Pizza Hut, have a pizza be your Valentine.
But it's about basically saying, like, have a pizza be your Valentine instead of asking a person. And it's not very good. Clearly, that's why I didn't post it. But yeah, I do want to do more original music for Miranda. I think it's fun to do. And it's fun to get on stage and sing the songs and have you guys know the songs. It's always pretty exciting.
Can you bring back fan and hate mail?
People ask me to do that all the time. And I always say yes because I always intend to. And then I film Miranda videos and I forget. Like, it's truly not because I don't like it. It's because I forget to put it in. And for those of you who don't know, fan and hate mail is like, I used to do fan and hate mail of the day. Every Miranda video, I would read hate mail and I'd read fan mail. And now I just forget. Like, literally just now, I filmed a video and I knew today, I was like, I'm going to film a video. I have to do fan and hate mail of the day. And I just forgot. I forget all the freaking time. What's my problem?
What was your worst dream you had as a child that you still remember today?
I've talked about it in A Queen's Corner, but there's the dream I used to have all the time. That was I was going down a slide at a park, and at the bottom of the slide there was a big hole, like a well type of thing, and Christopher went down the slide and hopped over the hole. Trent went down the slide, hopped over the hole, and I went down the slide and fell in the hole and couldn't get out. And my family looked in and saw me, like, Colleen, are you okay? And I was, like, crying and just clawing and trying to get out. And then they just walked away and left me there in the hole to die. And I still remember that dream. I was, like, 7 when I had that dream. And I had it, like, every night for a long time.
Are you ever going to film with Jenna?
With Jenna. Oh, Jenna Marbles. I was like, Jenna who? Yes, that is the plan. We'll see. But you never know. We've talked about it, but we haven't scheduled anything.
How's your adopted elephant?
Good! My little adopted elephant. I adopted an elephant, and you guys can too. It's in A Queen's Corner called I Adopted an Elephant, so if you want to do it, you can go check it out. We basically just spend a little bit of money to rescue an elephant because elephants are being poached every day and killed for their tusks, for fun, for sport. Like, people just do it because it's fun to kill animals, apparently. And it's really disgusting, and it makes me angry. So I went on the website and adopted an elephant, and I want to do more. You can also adopt, like, rhinos and giraffes and other things that poachers are doing to be horrible people. But go check it out. Go watch that video, and if you guys want to adopt an elephant, you can too. But they send you videos and pictures of updates, and it's a cool organization.
Are you going to Joshua Detown's shadow show?
If you guys didn't know, my fiance Joshua is doing his own show. So Josh has performed with me a lot, but now he's doing his very own show with his buddies Julian, which is Jenna's boyfriend, and Arnold, who is Hart's boyfriend. Hart is a makeup YouTube person who would probably be horrified by how I'm doing my makeup right now. But anyway, they're doing a show together. And it's called The Shadow Tour, and it's those three boys. And I may or may not show up at the shows. You never know. You're just going to have to buy tickets and find out if I'm going to be there.
Is it weird to have your life on YouTube the way it is?
No. I think it would be weird if it was like all of a sudden. If just one day I woke up and had millions of subscribers, I don't know how I would react, but it's been such a slow process. A lot of times people ask me like, what's it like to have a lot of people following you on YouTube? What's it like to like all of a sudden wake up and like have fame or whatever you want to call it? And to me, I'm always like, well, that didn't happen. I've been online for 7 years, so it's been gradual. It's like assuming someone just like woke up and knew how to ride a bike or woke up and just knew how to sing or woke up and just knew how to do something. That's not how it works. Like it went gradually, so I didn't notice it. Like it's not like I one day woke up and it was like all crazy. It's like I feel like now if I didn't do YouTube, it would feel weird. Like I'd feel like super weird and like I was missing a part of my life. So yeah, I'm only going to answer a couple more because I've been doing this for an hour and 20 minutes and that is far too long.
Would you rather meet Lorde or Taylor Swift? Please answer.
Taylor Swift. I don't know much of Lorde's music. I only know like the really popular ones, and the videos I've seen of Taylor Swift, she seems really sweet and quirky, and she loves cats, and I love cats, so we'd be best friends.
A personal question, have you ever gotten a bikini wax?
Oh my gosh.
That's pretty personal.
I have gotten a bikini wax, and it's terrible. Like, it hurts so bad. Don't do it. It's awful. I don't know how girls, like, do it all the time. I'm like, nope. Wow, it took me so long to do my eyebrows. I'm really paranoid about like doing my makeup in front of someone. This makes me feel really self-conscious. There, finished my makeup after 30 minutes.
Said, ask Colleen what's her dream role to play in a musical.
I don't know. I usually just say Baker's Wife from Into the Woods. That's my favorite musical, and that's my favorite role in that musical. Look, Ma, I'm done. Now I can have my phone.
There you go.
So now I can answer questions. I'm going to answer just a couple more. I will end this at 6:30, so it's been a full hour and a half of me talking to you guys. Wow, longest live chat ever. But I feel bad about not posting any videos this week, so it's fine. The super fans will watch. Wow, we're losing viewers by the minute. And my mascara is terrible. You can't even see my eyelashes. Okay. Wouldn't be a Colleen's Corner if I didn't burp. See, a lot of people stop watching and look what they missed out on. Some really beautiful burps. Okay, let me see. I'm going to answer just a couple more. This is the longest live chat I've ever done, I think. Caitlin said, I've been tweeting this whole time without the hashtag. I'm sorry, Caitlin. I just followed you, though. Twitter boy said, why is Miranda more explicit now? What do you mean? Miranda more explicit? Like, in what way? I don't think Miranda's gotten more...
like, innuendos?
Yeah. Oh, I maybe. I guess the innuendos have gotten more intense, but I don't know. I haven't noticed. It's a good thing to think about, though. I'll think about if I should reel it back. Madeline Rose said, if you could change your name to anything, what would it be? I wouldn't. I like my name. I like my name a lot. It's frustrating to say my name to people because they get confused and they're like, I say my name's Colleen and they're like, what? Isn't it pronounced Colleen? I'm like, for some people, but my family says Colleen, but I don't care. You can say Colleen and I'll respond. I'm not picky. And everyone always spells it Colin, C-O-L-I-N, which is kind of annoying. But I like my name. I wouldn't change it. All right, just a couple more. Oh my gosh, you guys are tweeting me like crazy. Josh Lean is Bay says, I love Gwen's socks.
They are Murphy and the socks that someone got you.
Oh, in Australia? My mom came to Australia, and so she stole some of my fan gifts. Let's see. Aww, this is sweet. Thurley Ballinger said, do you remember me? I waited 6+ hours in Dublin Airport to come meet you. And she posted this picture, which you probably won't be able to see, but there's pictures of me meeting the kids at Dublin. Well, I guess you're not kids. You're like pretty much adults at this point. At the Dublin Airport. And I say kids a lot when I'm talking about you guys. And that is not because I think you're immature. It's because I'm an old fart. Like, people are usually surprised to find out that I'm 28, but like, I'm old. So when I say kids, I just mean anyone who's not my age. but anyway, yes, I do remember you. That was really sweet to meet you guys at the airport. I really loved it. It was a nice way to get to Ireland. Katie Jung said, have you seen pictures of Jill Duggar's newborn baby boy? Yes, of course. I follow Jill Duggar on Instagram and Derek, and it was a really beautiful moment for me to see that she finally had her baby because I'm obsessed with the Duggars. Okay. Lindsay Blondie Blue 10 said, can you please give my BFF Bella a birthday shout out? It's tomorrow. It would mean the world to us. Yes. Bella, happy birthday. I love you, and you're beautiful. Have a great day. Okay, this is a good question and it's a good thing to address. Julia Tag 23 said, if VIP tickets are sold out at a show, can you wait outside after the show and meet you then? So there has been some drama over this. I can sometimes. So I have VIP tickets at my shows. And those VIP tickets mean you get to meet me, take a picture with me, do a little Q&A sometimes. Like, it's fun. The meet and greets are fun. However, the meet and greet tickets sell out really fast. And so a lot of times you guys will wait outside for me after the show. Well, after the shows, usually... Did you spill something?
Water bottle exploded.
Oh, or was it something else? But sometimes I can go out to greet you guys, and sometimes I can't. And that is because of many different reasons. Recently, I was in Australia. I couldn't go out to meet people who waited because, one, I was in really horrible, excruciating pain. And my mom can vouch for me on that one. I'd come off stage after the meet and greets just crying because my shoulder and back were in so much pain. And so I couldn't go out and stand in the cold for another hour to meet people because I was in so much pain I needed to get into bed and try to sleep. So that was why a lot of kids I couldn't meet in Australia, and I felt really bad about it. Sometimes we have a really early morning flight the next day. So if I get done with the show, do a meet and greet, and then pack up all the props and all the gifts, and then it's 11 p.m., I can't go meet people because it'll take a long time, and then I have to wake up a few hours later for a flight to the next city. Sometimes it's that, and sometimes it is because the security will not let me if it's not safe. So if there's too many kids and they're crowding the door and there's not enough security and they think that I could be hurt or Rachel could be hurt, not by you guys, but just because there's so many people crowding and there's no way to control it, or the street is too close to the door, so like someone could get pushed into the street because that has happened before. And there have been times where I've gotten in the car and people have banged on the door in the streets and caused traffic and almost got hit by cars. So those are the reasons I wouldn't come out to meet people after the shows. If I'm really, really sick or injured, if we have a super early flight the next day, or if security says I'm not allowed to. If those three things don't happen, I always go out and say hi. But I never encourage people to stay and wait to say hi to me because the thought of you standing in the cold for a while to wait to meet me breaks my heart if I can't go out and meet you. So usually I try to tweet or Snapchat like, I'm back at the hotel, or I can't come out to meet you guys tonight, I'm so sorry. Like, I'll usually let you know so that you're not waiting. And those are not to trick you tweets. Like, those are truly to let you know, like, don't stand and wait in the cold, please. Like, I don't want you to get sick. Anyway, that's that. But I've noticed a lot of people get mad that they waited and they didn't get to see me, and I feel really terrible about it. But sometimes I'll have like my assistant go out and like tell you guys like she's not coming, and like, so anyway, that's that. But I wish I could meet you all always. I wish I had enough VIP tickets for the world. I want to give you all a hug.
Can I have my ring back?
Darn it.
All right. One more question, and then I'm leaving, because this has been far too long. That was a really long-winded answer. I'm sorry. Sorry, guys. I'm trying to find a good one that you guys will all like. No, it's awkward because it's quiet. Oh my God, some of these questions are horrible, like so mean and dark. Vinny said, are you ever gonna come to a great city of Salt Lake, Salt Lake City? You've got a lot of fans here. Vinny, stay tuned. Got some good news coming for you pretty soon. Let's see. Sorry guys, I'm trying to find one that like you can all relate to so that it's not just like a random one. Let's see. Sorry guys, this is so annoying. Someone wants Andrew to sing.
I don't sing.
Let's see here. Oh my gosh, so many of you love the Biebs. A lot of you guys have like Bieber things. Sorry, I'm so annoying right now. I'm just trying to find one that like you'll all be happy with, because I hate going on Twitter after I sign off of these and everyone's like, you didn't answer my question. So I'm trying to find one that like relates to everybody, but I don't think I'm gonna find that. Okay. Someone said, why are you taking a YouTube break? I said it in my video of why I was taking a YouTube break. The last video I uploaded, I said why I was taking a YouTube break. I have injured my rotator cuff in my shoulder, which makes it very painful to use my right arm for anything, for editing, for texting, for everything. My body basically is just telling me to take a break, and so I'm taking a break. But it's explained in my last video. Can you sing a song before you leave us?
Yay.
That's a good one, because then I can sing it out. What should I sing, though? I don't know what to sing.
Sing to Mommy.
No. Karaoke. Tweet me what song to sing, and I'll sing it out. I'll sing the goodbye. Tell me what to sing on Twitter. I am checking my Twitter. Tell me what to sing on Twitter. No one's telling me. Literally no one's giving me any songs. Oh, I guess it might be delayed. Give me some song delays. Song choices, not song delays. Come on. While I'm waiting for you guys to send me songs, someone said, how close would you say you are to Joey Graceffa? Who said that? Joey's little Audrey said that. I'd say we're pretty close. Like, Joey's so sweet, and every time we see each other, we get really excited. If I had more free time, I'd want to spend it with Joey. Like, he's the nicest, sweetest, most happy, like, wonderful guy. I really, really love Joey a lot. So I'd say we're close, but I'd say we have the potential to be very, very close. Like, he's so, so sweet. I just wish I had more time. Okay, here we go. You guys are sending me songs. Finally. Take Me to Church. That's a boy song. People are singing me, telling me to sing something by Ariana, and like, there's no way I could even compare to her. So maybe I'll do, like, I don't want to ever sing Ariana songs because there's no way I could even come close to how awesome she is. But I'll try it. And it'll just be really bad. Yeah, everyone sings Ariana. Okay, everyone said One Last Time by Ariana, which Miranda did a cover of this. Check it out. And then I'm going to leave. I'll leave you all. Thanks for watching my live chat. I'm going to sing about 1 second of this because I'm going to hate my voice so much.
so high, I didn't see the fire. I know I should have thought it. At least I'm me and I'm feel like a better. Cause I know that I felt it. I should have done it better. Cause you don't know how I lie. And I know what I know when I know what you think you ever claim. All I said was leave it to me, yeah. And I know what I know when I know that you got it. One last time, I need to be the one who takes you home. One last time, I promise that I'll let you go. I'll take you to hold you home. I'll take you to
hold you home. That's not right.
One last time, I need to be the one who takes you home. I don't deserve it, I know I don't deserve it. But stay with me a minute, I swear I'll make it worth it. Can you forgive me? It's just temporary. I know that this is my fault. I should have been more careful. And I know what I know when I know she gives you everything before I couldn't give it to you.
Not the best singing you've ever heard in your life. Bye, guys.